revisions related to linear programming. The first point, that is the compilation of linear programming problem. So let us take an example. A company manufacturing three products. Product A, B, C, and its profit rupees 3, rupees 2, and rupees 4, respectively. The firm has two machines. Firm has two machines. That is P and Q. And these two machines, the firm has two machines P and Q, and the machine P and Q have 2000 and 2500 minutes with these two machines. Means P machine 2000 minutes with the Q machine, the available with this machine. And in order to gauge the maximum profit, formulate the given problem. So let us take this one chart. So try to understand the given problems. We have to formulate the given problem. A firm means one industry. They are manufacturing three products, A, B, C. Profit of that product is 3, 2, and 4 respectively. The firm has two machines, P and Q. Available times with the machine P, that is 2,000 minutes, and for Q, 2500 minutes. Now left side one chart is given. Product A, if you process on machine P, the unit processing time is 4. If you process product A on machine Q, unit processing time is 2. Similarly for B, unit processing time is 3 on machine P, 2 on machine Q. Then for product C, unit times, this all these times are in minutes, 5 and 4, P and Q respectively. But available times on P and Q machines are 2000 for P and 2500 on Q machine. Now we have to formulate this problem in order to get maximum profit. Okay, so how to formulate this problem? First of all, we have to take decision variables. So first decision variable. So decision variables in order to get maximum profit, we require the quantity to be produced. Quantity to be produced by machines for the each product. Okay. So let us consider this quantity. Each one, the number of product. Number of product A to be produced. X two, number of product. And X3, number of products. Now, in this given problem, quantity is not given. This quantity, let us consider X1, X2, X3. X1, number of quantity for A product, 2, that is number of quantity for B product, X3, number of quantity for C product. Okay, so quantity is not given, but profit for A, B, C, it is given. Then what is actually objective function? Now, in order to study this problem, what is our objective? The objective function. Now, our main objective to maximize the profit. Okay, so how to maximize profit? So in order to get maximized profit, what we require, how many quantity of A, B, and C can produce in order to get the maximum profit. Okay, and there is also one thing, minimize. Means sometimes the problem may be maximized. Maximize means maximize the profit. Minimize means minimize the cost of manufacturing. So our objective functions in this problem to maximize the profit. In order to maximize the profit, what we have to consider the unique profit for each product into quantity. For example, this X1, unique profit is 3 rupees. X2 unique profit is 2 rupees. X3 unique profit is 4 rupees. Okay. Profit into quantity. Profit into quantity. Profit into quantity. That is your maximized profit. Maximize profit. So maximize profit means X1 into 3, so 3X1 plus X2 plus so this is our objective function. Correct. Decision variables means quantity. Quantity can vary day by day, even 1 or 2 shifts. So let us we consider that quantity, that is our decision variable. Objective functions in order to maximize profit. So unique profit into quantity. So this is the maximize the profit. Now constraint. Next part to constraint. What is the constraint? Total number of minutes required to produce the product at machine P is given. Okay. Suppose P machine is given, then what is actually total number of minutes required to produce the given product by the machine P? Correct. Suppose the P machine, if we consider available unit minutes per product it is given. So for P machine, the constraint should be the quantity into the available times with that particular product on that machine. So constraint. So here the 4, 3, 5 for P machine. Okay. What is the quantity? Quantity X1, X2, X3 for respective product. The constraint is equal to 4X1 plus 3X2 plus 5X3. This is the for P. For P machine. This is for P machine and for Q. For Q machine, this will be X1 plus 2X3. So constraint means we have to complete our job. We have to complete our job within the given available times. Unit processing time it is given. Unit processing time it is given. So we have to go for multiplication of the quantity into unit processing time. And what is actually available times on P machine? So available times on P machine, that is the 2000 minutes, and available times on Q machine, that is 2500 minutes. So in this constraint, it should be less than or equal to available time for P machine. So this is our constraint. So in every linear programming, three parts will be there: decision variables, objective functions, and constraint. So whenever a problem is given, you have to formulate every problems into three things. This is our first thing, then this is our second thing, and this is our third. First, we consider decision variables, then second, objective functions, either maximize or minimize. Whenever maximize thing will be there, there should be profit. When minimize things will be there should be cost. Correct. So here's the, you have to convert all given these problems into three things. This is actually formulation of linear programming. This is actually formulation of linear programming. But whatever the decision variables are there, all this decision variable should be greater than equal to zero. Means our x1, x2, and x3. So this is the formulation of the linear programming problems. Okay. So once again, I will repeat, try to understand. So one industry is there. In that industry, three products they are manufacturing, A, B, C. A will get profit 3 rupees, B will get profit 2, and C will get profit 4. This is unit profit. Now in this industry, only two machines are there, P and Q. If you process A product on P, unit processing time is 4, means for one job, 4 minutes is required. If you process B product on P machine, for one product, 3 minutes is required. If you process C product on P machine, unit processing time is 5. Similarly for Q, but what is the actually available times on P and Q? Available times on P, that is 2000 minutes, and available times on Q machine 2500 minutes. Now you have to formulate this linear programming problem. So first, decision variable. What is the decision variable? Let us consider X1's, that is number of product produced, that is the A quantity, for B X2, or C X3. So here quantities, it is not given, but how much quantity we have to produce so that we will get maximum profit. Means what should be X1, what should be the X2, what should be the X3, in order to get the maximum profit. So these are the decision variables. And what is actually objective function? To maximize the profit. In order to maximize the profit, so unit price into quantity for each product, then addition of this, this is your maximum profit. This is our objective function. Means maximize the profit for P, 3x1, 2x2, 4x3, as per the table. As per the given profit, in order to maximize the profit. Now, next thing, as per table, there is given constraint. Constraint means there is a limitation. A product only 4 minutes will give for on P machine. For B product only 3 minutes. So these are the constraints. Now constraint for each product into quantity, that you have to write in the equation. So constraint for P, that is the 4x1, 3x2, 5x3, and available time, it should be equal to 2000 or less than this. Similarly for Q. Okay. So these constraints you have to write here. This profit you have to take from this, and these are the decision variables. Okay. So while going in this linear programming, only 3 things you have to remember. What is the objective function? What is the decision variable? And what is the constraint? Once all these things you will get, then the remaining part easily we will solve. So this is the first thing in our linear programming problem. Okay. So anybody having any doubt, you can ask. This is the formulation of linear programming problem. Is it okay?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Thank you. Now, this type of problems we can solve by 2 methods. One by simplex methods, and second is linear programming by graphical methods. Okay. So, in our operational research subject, first thing is the formulation of the problems. Whatever examples I have given, like this way you have to go, and after that you have to solve this problem by graphically and by simplex method. Solve means what? We have to find out the quantity. That means what should be the x1, what should be the x2, what should be the x3. So like this quantity we have to find. Okay. So this is the part of our linear programming problem. Now we have to go for one problem first by graphical methods. First by graphical methods. So this is the problem we have to solve by graphical method. So as per our previous method, maximize Z. Z means the profit. So already they have given this equation, constraint last part. So what is their objective? To maximize the profit, and you have to find out what is the value of x1 and x2 in order to get maximum profit. Whenever minimize things will be there, then there should be cost. Minimize problems will be there, there should be cost. Maximize problem will be there, then there should be a profit. Now we have to solve this problems by graphically. Now, in order to solve this graphically, first we have to find out the x1 and x2 and plot the graph on the graph paper. So here I will make one chart. So like this way I have made one chart. Constraint I kept in one column, coordinates it is kept on second column. Now we have to find out the coordinates of x1 and x2 to plot the graph. So here's right side there should be x axis and y axis. X1 and X2. Correct. So X1 and X2, we have to find out the value and plot the graph. Now in X axis, X2 should be zero. Means here X axis, X2 zero means here you have to put zero. And what is the X1 value? So x1 value it is zero, because we kept x2 zero and the x1 value the 80. So coordinate is 80 zero. Similarly for y axis, y axis is this axis. So zero, right? What is the x2 here? Okay. Similarly, you can go for next constraint. So next constraint x2 zero.
So x2 zero, x1 45 zero. Similarly here, x1 0, what is the x2? x1 0, so it is 15.
So this is the coordinates. So now you have to put these coordinates on x and y axis on graph paper. Okay, so you can make like this big graph. Like this graph paper is, you can plot by taking scale on graph papers and make like this way. Now let us take first constraint. What is actually on x-axis 80, and what is actually on y-axis, that is the 20. So first constraint you have to take, so this constraint you have to take, this 0 is here. Okay. And this 20 is here. So you can make this line. So this constraint, correct. Now second 45. So 45 ready here. This is the 45 margin. And here it is starting. So you can make the line. Okay, now inside the okay. Now you can give the name. And let us consider. So this BEC, these are the BEC. Within this feasible region, we have to find out the x1 and x2. So feasible regions means and these regions, it comes under the profit maximizations. Okay, now BEC, this point we have to consider. Now find out the coordinates and profit of the same. Okay, so up to here it is clear. Hello.
Yes, sir.
Okay, now we'll go to find out the coordinates of BEC, and we'll put in the first equation, that is maximization. Okay. So here I will make the charge related to this. Here I will make the charge.
So this point you have to take.
So related to point B, what is the coordinate of B?
0, 20. What is coordinate of B? 0, 20. 0, 20.
What is coordinate of E?
So on graph paper, we can find out the E value.
If you plot this graph on graph papers, then exactly E value you will get. So I calculated exactly E value, that is the
24 and 14.
Now, what is the value of C? What is the value of C? 45, 0.
So, C value 45, 0.
Okay. Now, you can put this value in the above equation. So, this value
you can put in this equation. This value. For this point, for example, z is equal to 40 by x1 plus 80 x2. So, this is
a formula you have to put your value for B points. Okay, so for B,
what is there? X1 0. 20. So here 40 by 0 plus 80 20. So this 20 you can put here, this 0 you can put here. What is the value? So this is the 160. So here we can write. Similarly, for C point, this 24 value here you can 24 plus 14, 80, 40. So what is the value of this? Calculate this.
So my answer, that is the 2200. 2200, my answer.
For C point,
my values, that is the 2020. Correct. So just you can put the coordinate value into this maximization Z equation x1 and x2. You will get that profit that you can write in the last column. So among these three, which have maximum value, which has, so here sir, this is our maximum value. Okay, so 2200, this is the maximum value. That means our x1 must be 24 and x2 must be 14. If it is in quantity, then x1 should be 24 quantity and x2 should be 14 quantity. If it is in times, then 24 for x1 and 14 for x2. Means you have to produce 24 quantity if you want to get maximum profit, and 14 quantity if you get maximum profit. So this is the actually our answer. Correct. That means x1 should be 24 and x2 should be 14. To get, and what is the z? Z should be 2000. So this is the graphical methods. Correct. Just I will revise and then we'll go for next simplex methods. So examples for graphical methods, it is given maximize z, that is equal to 45 x1 plus 80 x2. Constraint, it is given 5 x1 plus 20 x2 less than equal to 400, and 10 x1 plus 15 x2 less than equal to 450. Solve this problem by graphical method. So initially, by using constraint, you have to calculate coordinates on x-axis and y-axis. So x1 should be on x-axis, x2 should be on y-axis. So let us first constraint x-axis. When we want to calculate the coordinates on x-axis, x2 should be 0. So as per constraint, if you put x2 0, then the coordinates on x-axis, that is x1 is 80, comma 0. Y-axis, x1 should be 0, x2 you have to calculate and that should be 0, 20. For constraint number 2, correct? And after this, by using these coordinates, we have to plot the graph. On graph, you have to take the particular scale and whatever constraint equations are there, that equation lines, by using coordinates, you have to draw on graph papers. Now, after drawing these two lines, intersecting points and below that regions, that is the feasible regions, you have to consider. So the point below the feasible point below the intersecting points, it comes under the feasible region. Means only B, E, C point you have to consider for calculation of maximum profits. So B point coordinates, that is 0, 20, E coordinate, that is 24, 40, and C coordinate 45, 0. Now you can put this coordinate in first equation. For B point, if you put 0 and 20, then you will get profit 1600. For E point, x1 24, x2 14, then you will get profit 2200. Similarly for C, x1 45 and x2 0, you will get the profit 2025. So out of these three, which is the maximum? That is the 2200. That means our x1 should be 24 x2 should be 14 and maximum profit 2200. Correct. So this is the graphical method. Okay. Anybody having any doubt or shall I repeat this? Hello. Just anybody can give response to me so that I will repeat or proceed. Hello.
No problem, sir.
Hello, I am not getting.
No problem, sir.
It is okay. Okay, I think you have got this left. Shall I proceed? Hello? Hello? Okay, thank you. Now I got the message. So it's okay. And I hope that you got this concept. This is the graphical method. This is the complete structure. Any problems will come in your question papers whenever the writing exam is there. Then you can put this step by step things in your minds and try to solve this type of problems by graphical method. Now we'll go for simplest method. So this is the problem we have to solve by simplex methods. maximize z 12 x1 plus 16 x2 subjected to means constant it is given. So decision variables are x1, x2, and if you multiplications by profit 10 or 28 or 8, so should be less than 120 for first and less than 80 for second. Okay. Now, in this simplex methods, we have to add two surplus variables. So here, decision variables are two, x1 and x2. Accordingly, you can add surplus variable s1 and s2. If it is a three, you can add three surplus variable, that is the s1, s2, s3, correct? And make it equal. Okay, so here two decision variable. Okay, so you have to convert this constraint into equality. So here 8x1 plus 20x2 plus 0x1. What is that x1? X1 means decision surplus variables and coefficient, that is the 0. And you can make it equal to 120. So here 8x1 plus 20x2 plus 0x1 plus 0x2 inequality you have to convert into equality by adding surplus variables. If there are two decision variable x1 and x2, then you can add two surplus variable x s1 and s2. If it is three, then you can add s1, s2, s3. Okay, and converts inequality less than equal to this inequality, you have to convert into equality. This is our first thing. Okay. Now, what is the next thing? You have to make one initial simple table for this. So, like these tables you have to make, and what it contained in these tables, that is the basic variables and their coefficient. Okay, so initially BVI, basic variable coefficient, and here CJ, coefficient of decision variable, and here it is the basic variable. So what is the basic variables here? X1, X2, S1, and F2. Okay, and here you can write solutions. And here you have to write ratio. And what is the coefficient of this? You can take from here x1's coefficient of x1, coefficient of x2, coefficient of s1, s2, like this way. So here coefficient of x1 from maximum profit here 12, x2 16, and here it is 0. Correct. And whatever variables are there, additional variable, you can put here s1.
So what is the coefficient of S1 and 0? Coefficient of X2 and 0. Correct. Now as usual, you can write the value for constant 1. S1 is X1. It is the 20 and S1,
it should be 1 for 1 surplus variables. Okay, I think our time is over. Next lectures will continue at 1 o'clock. Okay, so we'll stop here.
Okay.